Well, the banner's up on the Green Monster today. The four schools taking part in Frozen Fenway 2012. Vermont and Massachusetts will be the first game of the doubleheader. Then the Border War, UNH, going at it against the University of Maine. That's a 7:30 game. The official announcement coming today. And the two head coaches of Game 2 joining us right now, Dick Umilli from UNH, Tim Whitehead from the University of Maine, making the trip down today to make the announcement. Tim, start with you. How exciting is it to be playing a game here at Fenway?
It's great. We're thrilled. We're really honored, University of Maine, to be in an event down here in the city of this magnitude, you know, a signature event like this. We're thrilled, and especially our captains. We got three of our four captains from the Boston area. O'Neill, you know, we got Flynn and Cornell. Those guys are pumped, yeah.
Yeah, I saw them all taking pictures in front of the Green Monster. They're pretty excited. You grew up here, and they couldn't play here as a baseball player, but you get the coach here. That's not bad.
No, it's pretty special. I tell you what, today was a terrific day, being down on the field, coming from Boston, being in Fenway. You know, I love coming into the ballpark and obviously talking about Maine and UNH playing a hockey game at Fenway. It doesn't get any better than that.
You know, a couple of years ago when BC and BU played their game here, obviously when you play that night, it's a league game. It's you know, it's all about winning the hockey game. It was the day before when they took the skate here that everyone looked like a little kid again. Something about being outside playing hockey. They don't get to do it much anymore.
They don't. Did BC and BU actually play a game?
I'll send you a ticket.
Yeah, okay, that's good. No, it is. It's fascinating, you know, to see how people come to life when they're on the pond. You know, we got a lot of, obviously, outdoor rinks up in Maine, but nothing like this one. It's going to be very special.
And obviously the NHL found something when they did that outdoor, that Winter Classic.
Yeah, I think it's the best thing that's happened in the NHL. That game has taken on an unbelievable magnitude of support, and I think it's the best thing that goes on.
You know, and I said before, as a kid growing up in Maine, it's not the same as guys who grew up here in Boston, you walk over to the ballpark. Coming to Fenway maybe once a year for me was an event. Yeah. And I think there'll be a feeling of that for people from Maine, New Hampshire, Vermont, who get to come down for that weekend of hockey.
Yeah, I think so. And I'm really proud of the Hockey East and the, you know, Fenway Sports Management for really having the courage to bring some teams from out of the Boston area, you know, into this venue. I think it's going to be fabulous. Our teams travel real well. I know Vermont and UMass do too. So I think it's going to be just a tremendous atmosphere.
Now, you come down here, and again, it'll be a practice day, and then you'll have the actual game. So you kind of do get, I know, again, for three periods, it's going to be all about winning a game, but you get to enjoy the weekend a little bit.
Oh, it'll be fun. It'll be exciting. That day, like you talked earlier, you have practice. It'll be a lot of fun. We come down, get in the hotel, and relax, get ready for the game. And then when we get on the ice, UNH and Maine always have a great game. So
Tim, you were talking today at the press conference. It's a lot hotter down here. Your mascot got a little overwhelmed today.
I don't know if you got video of it, but the poor guy came up, he's squeezing his head, trying to peek his head out. I'm like, what are you doing? There's kids here. They don't want to know, you know, you don't want them to see your face. And he's like, I'm really hot, coach. And then finally, I'm like, you're going to be all right. He's like, coach, honestly, I'm going to faint. I'm like, well, this isn't the Iraq war. You know, like, go ahead and take a breather, pour some water in. I guess they took him off. He was like hyperventilating. And, you know,
what I was getting at, it's not going to be that much hotter in January.
No, I'm sorry. No, it's going to be.
It won't help you out.
Got to give him a break. It was hot out there.
It was hot, and they were out there before us. So, he's going to be okay.
All right, he'll be back in January.
He's a bear. He's down here.
It's supposed to be hibernating in the summer. We're almost there. You guys will be on the ice before too long. You guys excited for the season?
Yeah, everybody came back to campus today, so, you know, they'll start the dry land training. We'll be on the ice in a couple of weeks, and before you know it, it'll be January 7th.
We were talking with Joe Bertagna a couple minutes ago. A lot of changes nationally in college hockey, but Hockey East just kind of continues, and obviously one of the strongest conferences in the country. How much does that mean to your programs to play that kind of competition week after week?
Oh, it's tremendous, and this type of signature event is a great indication of how strong our league is. The fact that we could take four schools that aren't in Boston and play, you know, two games like this and really bring it out, I think says a lot about not just the courage of our league commissioner, but also, you know, that we got a strong league, you know, right through and through. So we're excited about it.
Yeah, you know, the league, the Boston Bruins, they're back, Stanley Cup champions. You know, hockey in New England right now takes a backseat to nothing.
Yeah, I know. I had trouble getting my kids in camps this summer. Everybody's playing hockey again, and that's good for the sport. Guys, thank you. Great to see you, Tom. Congratulations on the announcement today being part of the event. It'll be UNH in Maine. That'll be the primetime game here at Frozen Fenway 2012. Later on in our pregame coverage tonight, we'll hear from Tu Cahoon and Kevin Sneddon of UMass and UVM about their involvement in Frozen Fenway 2012.